It's Eric David Benari. I kept saying David Eric for some reason today, Eric, but I apologize. Is it Benari or Benari?
Benari.
Benari. Perfect. Yeah. Well, look at that. So this is a great, great organization you have. It's called Techie Youth. And rather than me try to explain it, why don't you tell us a little bit about what this charity is all about, this organization?
Absolutely. So Techie Youth is a charity that was formed about 6-7 years ago. And the purpose of it was initially to help youth who are reaching their age of emancipation from foster care to be financially self-sufficient and stable financially prior to their age of emancipation.
What happens? That is age what, 18?
So it depends on the state. In New York, it could be anywhere between 18 and 21, which is an anomaly. Most states, it's either 18 or 21. But what happens to most of them statistically is they become homeless or incarcerated. Almost all of them. But it makes sense. I mean, like, logically, it's terrible, but it's heartbreaking. But the thing is that if they're in foster care, it means they have no family to take them. So now they hit that age, and then they lose their benefits, which is housing included. And if they can't financially self-sustain, they really have nowhere to go. So that's what happens.
So basically what you do is your organization gets in there and tries to get them before they start to go off to that route that takes them to hell and beyond. And one of the things that you're doing is on Monday, you're going to be giving more than 100 of these at-risk teens laptops to basically jumpstart their tech careers. Now, tell us a little bit about this program and how this whole thing came about.
Okay, so first off is we expanded from foster care because New York City asked us, can you also help homeless youth? Can you help pregnant and parenting teens and all these? We ended up with lots of different youth. So this coming Monday, we have all sorts of at-risk youth coming to pick up laptops because our program teaches them financial skills that are computer-based, how they can earn money while working remotely, and they need a computer for that.
Wow, that's smart. Wow.
Yeah. I mean, a lot of them do it from phones and stuff, but it's just really a tough way to make money from a telephone. So we've gotten donors to give us over 100 laptops to distribute to them. So that's what we're
talking with Eric David Benari. He's the founder and executive director of Techie Youth. How'd you get into this? Why is this particular cause so personal and so important to you?
It didn't start out personal. I knew nothing about foster care, and I ended up in a random conversation with a caseworker from foster care some 7 years ago, and she told me like what happens to this to youth who are in foster care and they reach their age of emancipation. And I was working in tech. I was a chief technical officer of a company, and I had previously been in Yahoo and a few other organizations. And I just said, I have to do something about this, and can tech fix the problem? And as it turns out, it can.
Wow. Can you give us any little success stories of some of the kids that you've worked with?
So we've had a lot of success stories in many different unexpected ways. So my favorite story is one youth who we trained to be a help desk support technician ended up teaching tech to kindergartners and first graders in Harlem. So it was like, that was the greatest thing, because he's basically repeating what
paying
we did.
Paying it forward.
Yeah, paying it forward, exactly.
Yeah.
How do you find the foster children that you end up mentoring and helping train?
So initially, we were literally going into their group, foster care group homes, which is like a modern-day orphanage, and recruiting them straight out of there, and literally, individually, like just persuading them to come to our classroom. But at this point, we work with New York City, and they send us the youth, which is great, because there's 3,000 teens in foster care in New York City alone.
And final question, how challenging is it to get in with some of these kids? I mean, do they put up a fight, or are they mostly receptive to you?
It's interesting because we work with lots of at-risk youth, and it's different depending on the demographics. So the foster kids are great. Honestly, it's pretty easy with them. But like juvenile justice youth, those are the tough ones because they don't want to be there. A lot of them are in second chance in programs to avoid incarceration, whereas if they don't come to class in our program, they get put back in incarceration. So they really don't want to be there, but they just would rather be at Techie Youth than going to jail or juvenile justice.
How can we help out?
We need donations terribly. We work on about 5% of the budget of most other organizations that have 3,000 youth and this amount of care, because our program is 150 hours long for 3,000 youth. Mm-hmm. And we're literally on a tiny shoestring budget. We need donations really badly.
Okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to post it on Jet Set Juliet and on the 77 WABC site and the 77 WABC early news site, Morano.
Absolutely. All my stuff as well. What's the website?
TechieYouth.org, TechieYouth.org.
I want to talk to you after this because I would really like to help you out. Go in and deal with some of these kids. I think that's a wonderful thing you're doing, and I'm happy that you're here.
Thank you. I'm happy to be here.
Thanks for waking up early. Sorry about that. All right. Appreciate it. Thank you very much, Eric David Benari, for joining us. Techie Youth.
5:37. Let's get a look at traffic and transit on the 7s with Joe Nolan. Good morning, Joe.
That was awesome. Thanks. Listen.